Most people don't even know me by Eric Berth. If you would say Eric Berth, they'd probably say, who are you talking about? I mean, I pretty much have my contact at every club, every hotel, every strip club, limo company, whatever. I have my go-to guys. I'm known for having all high rolls, big businessmen, and I get the job done. We're looking to leverage our relationships, our connections, and our experience that way we have at every limo company.
Buses. I've flown in 22-hour plane rides. I've been away from my family. You know, married, three kids. I have a 12-year-old daughter, 7-year-old son, and a 6-year-old son. I've been married going on 10 years. Now, you know, people that can afford to have bodyguards, real legitimate bodyguards, they have money to go and spend 15, 20, 30 grand on a night of partying. So being in a relationship in a situation like that can be a little stressful. You gotta really be open on the trust.
This is an idea that Danny and I both have been juggling around in our head for years, because we've been at this game for so long that I'm like, you know, enough's enough. I picked up the phone. I said, Danny, I think it's our time. We want every angle of security, big or small, covered, no matter what it is.
I'm trying to figure out how to use this craft of what I've learned in the industry and team up with the right people have the same mindset that I have.
Oh, my baby.
You want to start the business? This is the fucking guy that we need.
Yeah, I can find one baby.
This stuff, bro.
I can always take my second baby.
Oh, really? You bring this guy into my house with that? That's the first time I met the guy. He's got two guns in my house.
Your life is dangerous. You never know what happens.
Yeah, life's dangerous when you're whipping two guns at him, I just mentioned. If I could only learn Russian, that would be half my battle. Every word he says, I don't know what he says.
Always, if you need to be pull trigger or what, I'm always ready to do.
Yeah, I hear you, but I don't understand you. Well, it looks like he's gonna work out, and he does know his job.
Day in the life of a bodyguard. Glamour, no, you get your hands dirty. You have to put on people like this. That's what makes bodyguard so special.
We're hiring kind of like an assistant, administrative girl. I'm gonna get the specifics of all my emails and everything pertaining to business that I need to take care of when we forward on to you. And this is where you're gonna start.
My job is to keep everything very legit and very clean. That way we've got releases for passengers that are getting in our cars. We're taking care of insurances. So if I seem harsh, it's just because I'm coming next.
Guy. You know, it takes the size, the intelligence, you know, how to react to situations quick, you know, the tactical experience.
Don't call it a comeback. I've been here for years. I'm rocking my pants. What's up with the beer? Making the tears rain down like a monsoon. Listen to the bass go boom, explosion. Overpowering, over the competition. I'm towering, wreck his shot.
As a bodyguard, you always need to be prepared for the most slightest action, the most extreme action. There could be times where, for instance, you may be with a celebrity that somebody doesn't like. They may spit at a celebrity or throw something at a celebrity. Or it could be in turn, they could pull a gun on a celebrity.
I have clients that always have a lot of money on them, and a lot of jewelry, and they're always a mark to everywhere we go. And feel we can use everything that we learned today out in the field when there's high-risk clients in high-risk areas. Just like Muhammad Ali, they call them Cassie.
want to introduce him to the more entertainment side of the business of the security world.
Hi, you must be Boris.
Everybody's talking at me. I don't hear words they're saying. Only the echoes of my mind. People stop and stare. I can't see their faces. Only the shadows of their eyes. I'm going where the sun keeps shining.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready. Now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but step over my blue suede shoe.
You seen Elvis?
But now, honey, lay off of them shoes.
He is not in the building.
Don't you?
I need him in the building.
Blue suede shoe.
I know my parents seen Elvis, but I'm not that old.
What's this guy's name?
Elvis. He's Elvis. What do you think he is?
Elvis.
Elvis.
He goes by Elvis?
They all think they're Elvis. No, no, no. All these guys think they're Elvis. If you call him anything else, they don't even know who you're talking about.
Really?
Go find suede Elvis.
Shoes. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Yeah! Blue, blue, blue suede shoes, baby. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Well, you can do anything with they hold for my blue suede shoes.
Bodyguarding, this is Janella.
Oh, hey, Janella.
Hey, Brad. Good. How are you doing? Brad, we can definitely take care of you, dear mom. I got you.
You have a problem? So staring at a woman is not doing my job. Boy, you know I am a body. A body. Cosmonaut driving 45 miles an hour. I don't think I'll get there on time. I don't even think I'll get there at this point. It's fine. Do you think you can speed it up just a little bit? I've been dealing with this the entire trip. He doesn't speak English.
Don't worry about my English. My English is pretty good.
I'm on the phone.
Why are you going this way?
That's a short.
Is that a short?
That's short, sir.
I'm here every month. It's not a short.
I don't understand why we're taking a right turn and a left turn, now another left turn, now on the freeway.
Who is driver? Who is here driver? Just ask.
You let everybody in the country? This is what you get.